Hi there, everyone. It is currently the 4th of September 2011, and out here in the Western Pacific, we continue to watch two separate systems. Starting off here with Tropical Storm Talas, or Tropical Depression Talas via JTWC. JMA still holds this as a tropical storm, though. Current winds about 40 gusting up to 55 knots. This is all via JMA, by the way. And they're continuing to expect precipitation to move across much of Japan here as this drifts off towards the northeast, actually. Radar imagery still indicating high amounts of cloud tops throughout Honshu, and this is really going to exasperate the situation out here. And that situation is upwards of 1500 millimeters of rainfall in certain locations here along the east coast. Actually, just put that in kind of perspective for people that are watching the stateside, that's nearly 5 feet of rain that has fallen here in the last 48 hours throughout many of these areas. Really, a lot of these rain bands just coming onshore and continue to compile this region throughout here. Tons of flooding being reported right now, mudslides, landslides. Rainfall has continued to be the epitome of the system. It continues to affect this entire region. And if we zoom in on this radar imagery here, you can see these heavier rain bands continuing to move onshore. I know I don't have this in a loop right now, but these are moving onshore and over much of central Honshu here. So even though this system has been finalized by JTWC and still is actually much weaker than it has been in the last several days via the winds, you still have a lot of this coming onshore indicated by this radar imagery here. And unfortunately, there has been upwards of 9 reports of deaths and upwards of 16 people missing as of right now. So hopefully those people are found. We don't have any more reports of any deaths with this system. But really, the water and the high amount of precipitation and flooding is the main concern or the main system and what's causing all this damage, deaths, and missing people. And also upwards of about 50 people injured right now, all due to these same effects. As noted at landfall, though not that intense with this system, but as shown here, it did bring us the storm surge with it and a lot of high waves, but also that massive amount of precipitation. But as for today, though, as already noted, it is continuing to weaken. You do see this leaf starting to form off of this, and it really is going to get much weaker. Also, an excessive amount of vertical wind caused by the westerlies up in this region, and that's also causing it to get weaker. Actually, if we click on the vertical wind shear chart and just overlay a lot of these differences in between in the vertical of the wind speeds and direction, you see upwards of about 50, even up to 80, 90 knots of wind shear along the northern periphery of this right now. So this is also causing it to knock over, and it's going to quickly rush off towards the northeast, and that's actually being indicated via JTWC here with the final warning of Tropical Depression 15W or Talas here, just moving it quickly off towards the north-northeast about 13 knots, and as indicated here, they're actually showing about 25 knots of wind. JMA does have it slightly higher, about 40 knots of winds, and that's mainly coming off some reports near the shore here, but as I already stated before, the winds are not the main issue. It's still the continuous amount of rainfall that continues to pummel much of southern Japan here as this system continues to track off to the north. But that is all for right now on Talas. I do want to zoom out real quick and mention the other tropical system out here. That is 16W. JMA does have it as a tropical as well. It is moving very quickly off to the north, about 30 to 35 knots right now, and expecting this not to make landfall. It's going to continue to drift off towards the north, and you can see Talas quickly moving off towards the northeast as well here. Well, these two are going to collide. It's not going to create a superstorm as some people non-meteorologically termed would expect, but it really actually is going to weaken both of these systems, combine them together, and continue them off towards the north and eventually northeast as this kind of is going to shear up and just destroy it overall. So really good news as far as the fact that Tala is going to push a storm away from the coast, and this is JTWC's warning on this system, basically keeping it on the northerly track, and then it goes extratropical really quick, only maxing out intensity about 55 gusting up to 70 knots, so keeping it at tropical storm intensity unlike yesterday where it was up to typhoon intensity. But they hopped off on it, and really good news there as it is going to stay away from any major populated areas. Could get up here towards the coast of Kamchatka and much of the Kuril Islands, but a very low population up here as well, and by the time it does reach up this region, it'll be extra tropical, so nothing really worse than many of the northerly or polar lows that this area experiences. But that is all for today, everyone. Thanks again for listening to WesternPacificWeather.com. I do end with this satellite direct total precipitable water here, just showing the high amount of precipitation here with Talas as it did make landfall, indicated here in the very dark red, that's indicating those heavier rain bands that came ashore, so really just showing here compared to every everything else that this system had an exceptional amount of water vapor imagery with it. Also, I do want to note the development over here towards the right of our newest tropical depression just slowly off or quickly off to the north here as well. But thanks again for listening. If you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, you can post them here at westernpacific.com or at the YouTube channel as well. But thanks again, and have a great day. Stay safe out there, everyone, and I'll have another update tomorrow.